Hi everyone, Ileane Smith here. Guess what? Time to clean up your Google Plus circles. Circloscope. It's the only Google Plus circle management tool that's going to let you find inactive users, people who don't follow you back, and those annoying blue heads, meaning people that haven't even uploaded a profile picture to their account. Before I start showing you the tutorial for using Circloscope, I want to show you some social proof, so to speak. These are the results that I'm getting. Growing my following on my Basic Blog Tips Google Plus page, which was something that I had sort of ignored. I mean, I was posting to the page, but I wasn't really trying to reach out and expand my network there. So now that I have Circloscope, I'm able to add some targeted people to circles. When I say targeted, I mean that they have shown interest in events or in people or posts that I know are the type of content that I produce. I added some of those people to my circles, and now it's time to see how many of them, or if any of them, are adding me back. So this 23 is probably the most I ever had in one day of notifications here on my page. It looks more like what I would have on my profile. So see, added you back, added you back, added you back. You know, this proves that it's working, because these people that I have added, and in some cases their pages, they're people who are active. Notice that they all have, you know, profile pictures, or they have, as I mentioned earlier, engaged with a post or an event. Look, more, added you back, added you back. And this is just in the last 24 hours or less since I started adding people using Circloscope. So now let's go over and see how it's done. For this tutorial, I would like to use the example of my friend Mia Voss. Mia has the Mia Connect Power Chat, and she puts on the most fantastic events, and she gets a lot of engagement on her events. So this particular event, she also happened to have some people that I know are very popular and have similar content. For example, Cynthia Sanchez, who is from Oh So Pinteresting, and my friend Renee Christine, who you may remember I did a YouTube collaboration with before. Some of these other ladies, they all have a lot of authority in their areas of expertise. And I know that the people that engage with this particular event will probably be interested in my content. So we're going to grab the URL from this event, and this is what we're going to use in Circloscope. So let's copy that. Okay, so the suspense is over. We're now finally over into the Circloscope dashboard. And the first thing I want to do, as I mentioned, I want to focus on my page and not my profile. So we go in here, and I'm going to change this over to my page. From the dashboard, we want to go into events. Now, of course, I only want the people who are not in my circles. So I'm going to say they posted to this event. Put the URL in. And there were 75 people. But we want to add filters just to be on the safe side. And I want to show you how you can add filters. And there's several different choices you have here. So one of the things that I always suggest you do is not to include blue heads. Pay attention because this is real important. You have to click this twice to exclude them. See how that changed into a X mark? Now, if I wanted to, I could say, let's make sure these people are still active, even though that event wasn't that long ago. But let's say we want to make sure they were active in the last 3 weeks. And so that's how you would do that. But you see here, you have other choices, months, days. Now, if the event that you're going to use happened recently, then you can just skip this part about activity because they were obviously active recently because the event just happened recently. But in this case, it was a couple of months ago, so I'll say in the last 3 weeks. As you can see, if you remember before, it was 75. Now we're down to 64. Okay, so it makes a difference to go ahead and narrow down. So now I am not going to waste any time. I am simply going to select all. That means I've selected all 64 and I'm going to add to circles. Now I could add to an existing circle, but in this case, I want to remember that there's a Mia Connect circle. And it just confirms in case I did something wrong there. Now it's going to add those 64 people. So as I mentioned, I know that Mia gets a lot of interaction. So I may go and pick a couple of her other events because I'm not going to have to worry about overlap because I'm going to tell the tool. Let's go back to the home page here. You have different choices when it comes to events that I only want the people that posted to the event that are not in my circles. So now I could use that same event and come back and say the people that said that they may be going. All right. Or even the people that said that they're not going. At least you know those people are active enough that they care enough that they say, you know, I'm not going to just completely ignore this. I'm going to just let her know that I'm not attending. So that's how you do that when it comes to events. And I would just repeat that a couple of times. The only thing, there is a limit. You can't add too many people in a 24-hour period. And since I don't have that many people in my circles, I can't really add a lot. And it varies by person. So just go for it until you get that little warning from Google Plus that'll tell you that you've added too many for that day. And it'll tell you, wait 24 hours, and then you can come back and add some more. Okay? And in the end, if you find that you've added a lot of people and they haven't added you back, then you come in here and you just get rid of those that have not added you back. Simple enough. You just come in here and say, not following back. Okay, and that's how you do that. But remember, in the meantime, keep putting up relevant content to keep people interested in your page. Folks, that's it for today, but make sure you subscribe to this channel so you can keep up with all the latest in blogging, social media, and YouTube. Talk to you soon. Peace.